Hey everybody, I'm back to do another haul, and this is specifically from one brand. It's the Gemakid brand, if you guys have heard of it. Some representatives from Gemakid contacted me maybe about a month and a half ago about testing out some of their products and just, you know, maybe talking about them if I like them. So I decided to do it in just a haul format, and I'll just let you guys know my opinion on everything. I'm not getting paid for this video, everything's honest. I received these to test out, and I'm not gonna lie to you guys about them. I'm not forcing you guys to buy them either. And basically, Gemakid has three separate lines. Gemakid is sold in Target, and it's everything in the red packaging is sold at Target. They also have their Makeup School line, which you can't find at Target, nor can you find the Gemakid Pro line at Target, but you can find them online and in certain stores, which I will type everything out in the info box. Just check out the info box if you have any questions about where to find anything. So I'm going to start off with the Target stuff, JK line, and this is their Lip ID. So this is the packaging. It's a really cute packaging. It's a squeeze tube and it says Lip ID on it. Color Adapt Gloss. And pretty much what it does is it applies clear. You can see that. Basically what it's supposed to do is the formula of it is supposed to adapt to the pH level of your lips and then give you the perfect color gloss or whatever has it. And it's supposed to give you like nice stain looking, you know, lips. I guess it's different for everyone's lip color. So I only can speak for my lip color. And this is pretty much my natural lip color. It's pretty dark. So I guess I wasn't expecting too much. I don't really like having super dark lips, so I don't usually wear super dark lip colors. I like nude lip colors usually, or light pinks. And this adapted to like a ruby, mauvey red color for me. Wasn't that flattering. The texture of it's not sticky though, but I don't know. I was in love with it, but I mean, it is a cool thing to try out. Because, you know, it adapts differently for everyone. Okay, the next thing from the Target line is their Front Cover Concealer. I put everything in the box just to show you guys. And this is what it looks like. And I got mine in mid, the second shade. It's a twisty concealer with a little brush applicator that stays really, really soft. And all you do is just twist it and you hear it make that noise. See that the concealer just comes out. The concealer itself is not bad. I like it more for under eyes rather than around the face because it's like a liquid consistency. And I like liquid concealers, but I don't really like the packaging. The concept's good, but the fact that sometimes the product spews out or it gets messy, you know, it's not exactly what we need. The concealer isn't bad. Next, I'm gonna go into their Makeup School line. This is the Stardust Cream Shadow. It looks like this, and all you do is just pull it out and twist it, and there's a cream shadow. It's like a light, almost taupey brown. Okay, my opinion on this, it rolls on really smooth, packaging's really good. I don't see anything wrong with it. If you're the type who really likes cream shadows, I'm sure you'd really like them. I don't wear cream shadows a lot by itself. I usually use them just as like a base. But aside from that, I'm really happy with the cream shadows, but they only come in like 4 or 5 shades if I'm right, not too many. Next is the Lash Extension Mascara. It's supposed to be volumizing. And I got mine in black, of course, since I basically only wear black mascara. All these products come with little instruction things in each of their boxes. The tube itself is really, really fat. It's kind of short and stubby, but the packaging is really, really cute. The brush is really weird because it's like angled and it's fat. Mascara is not waterproof, so you know it didn't really work that well. For me, and it didn't do amazing volume either. Aside from the fact that it wasn't waterproof and doesn't come in waterproof, I wasn't exactly happy with it, so it definitely wasn't one of my favorite products. But if you're the type who likes really, really big brushes of mascara, you should definitely check that out. Next thing from their Makeup School line is a cream blush. That's the packaging, and this is in guava, and that's what it looks like. It's like really bold and loud, but when you lightly apply this, it's like the prettiest color. Subtle pink if you go really, really lightly. Of course, that was a lot, but you get the point. The last thing from their Makeup School line is a eye quad, and this is what the back looks like. It tells you what colors are what. This is the plum quad. It has a big mirror, little applicator, and then this really cool design for the eyeshadows. They're really, really pigmented, which I really like, as you can see. Super silky. I do like the eyeshadows. They're very pretty. There's not a lot of options when it comes to colors, but the texture and pigmentation and blendability of it is really, really good. And the last product by Gemakid is their Gemakid Pro. This is their Skin Renew Bio Complex Veil. Sounds really scientific, and it's really, really huge. It's like the size of my head. And this is in nude, the shade nude. And it's basically a primer, in a sense, for your face. But it's also, like, a tinted moisturizer, in a sense, because it's supposed to moisturize, prime, prep, and add tint. Also, like, illuminating your face. And there's only two shades, if I'm right. I like the fact that it comes with a pump, though, and it has, like, a squeezy packaging. That's really nice. The thing I really don't like about it is that it's really watery. You can see it's running down my hand. It comes out like an oil, in a sense, if you can see that. It has like a decent tint to it, but to me it's like a face stain, you know, because it's just so light and such. And I'm not really a fan of really, really watery products. And regardless, it just stays really watery and oily, but you can add more and more to get more coverage. I guess it would look really, really nice on normal skin or dry skin. For me, it's just too oily for my preference. It doesn't make me more oily. I just don't like the texture of it. I don't really like wearing it, though, because I like a little bit more coverage. It's pretty sheer. The coverage I built by applying more, the more shiny I looked. And that wasn't really my thing. But aside from that, I mean, the concept's really cool. It's worth a try if you're looking for something that's like an all-in-one type of makeup thing. I have been a fan of Gemma Kidd, at least her eyeshadow wise, because I've been using some more eyeshadows from Target. I heard her bronzer is really good. I didn't have a chance to try that, but I would say my favorite thing from the group is the cream blush in Guava. I would skip out on the mascara just from personal preference, and I really do love the eye quad. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this opinion and haul of these products. Again, everything's completely honest. Check out the info box if you have any questions. Also, link off the tutorial for the makeup I'm wearing in the box. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.